Election day is just 5 days away, with control of the legislatures at both the state and national level in the balance.
All this week, we've been spotlighting some of the most hotly contested races in Minnesota. And tonight, Chief Political Reporter John Croman looks at the battle in the 2nd Congressional District.
Congresswoman Angie Gregg is asking voters for another 2 years in office in the 2nd District, which extends south from the Twin Cities. Redistricting changed the shape of CD2, so she's having to win over voters who've never seen her name on the ballot.
I am always going to stand up to protect Medicare and Social Security, and I'm always going to stand against Big Pharma.
She faces a rematch with Tyler Kistner, a Marine Corps veteran who came very close to beating Craig in 2020 and feels even better about his odds this time.
You can see the desperation of the Democrats, and it kind of gives you a little bit of light of where this race is heading, the momentum of one side over another.
When the two debated, Kistner denied claims that he opposes abortion without exceptions.
I'm pro-life, with the exceptions of rape, incest, and life of the mother. But this issue should be left to the states.
When in the hell did the Republican Party become the party of telling people what they can do in their doctor's offices?
And fell in line with Pelosi and Biden.
Republican attack ads have blamed Joe Biden and fellow Democrats like Angie Gregg for fueling inflation with government spending.
What made me run for Congress again was these disastrous policies of President Joe Biden, Congresswoman Gregg, and their Democratic allies who have made it harder for us to just have an affordable living.
The Poynter Institute's PolitiFact says it's mostly false to blame Biden for inflation because the bulk of federal spending aimed at rescuing the economy happened before Biden took office. And inflation is a worldwide phenomenon caused by supply chain disruptions and labor shortages.
There was no doubt that we were going to have challenges, but I've been focused on working on solutions.
Gregg says she's proud of her work on a bill that ended the family glitch in the Affordable Care Act and a bill that extends survivor benefits to families of police officers who die from suicide because of post-traumatic stress. It's one of the reasons the statewide group MPPOA endorsed her.
It's been disappointing and a little bit egregious that the GOP super PACs are somehow trying to tie me to the defund the police movement when I'm literally out here providing federal dollars for the police.
Now, this is one of the true swing districts in the nation. That's why national Democrats, national Republicans have poured a lot of money into this race. Now, the wild card is the legal marijuana party candidate, Paula Overby, who died October 5th but is still on the ballot. Coming up on Breaking the News, Kent Erdahl will look at the ins and outs of that issue. Back to you.
All right. Thank you. As you get ready to vote, if you have questions about the Craig versus Kistner race or other races in the state, we have resources ready for you. Text the word vote to 763-797-7215 if you'd like a link to our voters toolkit.